All right, it's time to wrap up. Here's what I hope you've taken away from this unit. Remember APOD: analyze, parallelize, optimize, and deploy. The important points here are: do profile-guided optimization at every step, and deploy early and often rather than optimizing forever in a vacuum. I can't emphasize this enough. Optimization takes effort and often complicates code, so optimize only where and when you need it, and go around this cycle multiple times. Now, most codes are limited by memory bandwidth. So compare your performance to the theoretical peak bandwidth, and if it's lacking, see what you can do about it. Things that will help improve, in order from most to least important, are: assure sufficient occupancy. Make sure you have enough threads to keep the machine busy. This doesn't mean having as many threads as you can possibly fit on the machine, but you do need enough that the machine is basically busy. Coalesce global memory accesses. Really strive to see if you can find a way to cast your algorithms that you achieve perfect coalescing. And if you can't, consider whether you can do a transpose operation or something that will get poor coalescing once, but then put the data into a memory form where all your subsequent accesses will get good coalescing. Remember Little's Law. In order to achieve the maximum bandwidth, you may need to reduce the latency between your memory accesses. And so, for example, we saw that in one case, we spent too much time waiting at barriers. By reducing the number of threads in a block, we were able to reduce the average time spent waiting at a barrier and help saturate that global memory bandwidth. We've talked about minimizing the branch divergence experienced by threads. Remember that this really applies to threads that diverge within a warp. If the warps themselves diverge, in other words, if all the threads within a warp take the same branch, go in the same code path, then that comes for free. There's no additional penalty for threads in different warps diverging. It's only when threads within a warp diverge that you have to execute both sides of the branch. As a rule, you should generally try to avoid branchy code, okay, code with lots of if statements, switch statements, and so on. And you should generally be thinking about avoiding thread workload imbalance. In other words, if you have loops in your kernels that might execute a very different number of times between threads, then that one thread that's taking much longer than the average thread can end up holding the rest of the threads hostage. All that said, don't let a little bit of thread divergence freak you out. Remember, we analyzed a real-world example of dealing with boundary conditions at the edge of an image and figured out that, in fact, the if statements to guard the edge of the images weren't really costing us very much. Only a few warps ended up being divergent. If you're limited by the actual computational performance of your kernel rather than the time it takes to get the data to and from your kernel, then consider using fast math operations. This includes things like the intrinsics for sine and cosine and so forth that go quite a bit faster than their math.h counterparts at the cost of a few bits of precision. And remember that when you use double precision, it should be on purpose. So just typing the literal 3.14, well, that's a 64-bit double precision number, and the compiler will treat it as such. Whereas typing 3.14f tells the compiler, hey, this is a single precision operation. You don't have to promote everything I multiply this by or add this to be a double precision number. Finally, if you're limited by host device memory transfer time, consider using streams and asynchronous memcopies to overlap computation and memory transfers. And that's it. Now go forth and optimize your codes.